Good morning.
Am I sick?
We welcome all visitors to Holy Family Parish. Today's celebration is all about those who are called. Amos, the prophet, the 12 apostles, and us, all who have been baptized. What do we have in common?
That's fine. I like the chat.
Amos and the 12 responded to God's call within the context of their everyday lives. And us? Perhaps today is a good day to pray to God for the grace to hear God's call and respond to it in our own everyday lives. Let us praise and thank God by singing in the Missalette, number 351, Sing Praise to Our Creator. number 351.
Sing praise to our Creator, redeemed of heaven's grace, God's children by adoption, baptized in living grace. Praise the Holy Trinity, undivided unity. Holy God, mighty God, God immortal, be adored. To Jesus Christ give glory, God's co-eternal Son, as members of His body, we are in Christ made one. Praise the Holy Trinity, undivided unity. Holy God, mighty God, God immortal, be adored. Now praise the Holy Spirit, poured forth upon the earth, who sanctifies and guides us, confirmed in our rebirth.
It's fine if it is. It's just fine if it is. Do you take communion? You want me to have Rita come in here?
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
As we gather to celebrate these sacred mysteries, the readings for today remind us that the Church is called to be missionary, to carry out Christ's command to go forth and to spread His message of love to all the world. Christ's disciples are sent out two by two to cast out demons, to heal the sick, to forgive sin. And so we too approach the Lord with hearts that are humble as we call to mind our sins and ask for His mercy and forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you are the everlasting word of truth. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you forgive our transgressions. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And Lord Jesus, you bring healing and comfort to our weary world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you,
we give you thanks for
your great glory.
Our God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus,
Let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Amaziah, priest of Bethel, said to Amos, "Off with you, visionary, flee to the land of Judah. There earn your bread by prophesying, but never again prophesy in Bethel. For it is the king's sanctuary and a royal temple." Amos answered Amaziah, "I was no prophet, nor have I belonged to a company of prophets. I was a shepherd and a dresser of sycamores. The Lord took me from following the flock and said to me, 'Go, prophesy to my people Israel.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavens. as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world to be holy and without blemish before him. In love, he destined us for adoption to himself through Jesus Christ. In accord with the favor of his will, for the praise of the glory of his grace that he granted us in the Beloved. In him we have redemption by his blood, the forgiveness of transgressions, in accord with the riches of his grace that he lavished upon us. In all wisdom and insight, he has made known to us the mystery of his will in accord with his favor, that he set forth in him as a plan for the fullness of time, to sum up all things in Christ, in heaven and on earth. In him we were also chosen, destined in accord with the purpose of the one who accomplishes all things according to the intentions of his will, so that we might exist for the praise of his glory, we who first hoped in Christ. In him you also, who have heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and have believed in him, were sealed with the promised Holy Spirit, which is the first installment of our inheritance toward the redemption as God's possession, to the praise of his glory. The word of the Lord.
Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus summoned the 12 and began to send them out two by two and gave them authority over unclean spirits. He instructed them to take nothing for the journey but a walking stick, no food, no sack, no money in their belts. They were, however, to wear sandals, but not a second tunic. He said to them, wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave. Whatever place does not welcome you or listen to you, leave there and shake the dust off your feet in testimony against them. So they went off and preached repentance. The 12 drove out many demons, and they anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There is a little-known story that follows up to today's gospel. You won't find it in your Bible at home, but I'd like to share it with you today. So Jesus tells his disciples to go out two by two and to take nothing with them but just a tunic, no money or anything like that, and just the sandals upon their feet. So James and John depart that day, two of Jesus' disciples, and they go about a day's journey, and they have to set up camp for the night because they haven't quite reached the town. Jesus has told them to Whatever town accepts you, go ahead and settle in there for a while and preach in my name. But they haven't quite reached the town yet, so James and John decide to just pull off the beaten path and to set up their tent and to get all their stuff ready, and they settle in for a good night's sleep. Midway through the night, James feels a little nudge at his side, and he realizes it's John poking him in the side, and he says, John goes, James, look up, what do you see? And James looks up and he says, I see so many beautiful stars above us. And John says, yeah, what does that tell you? And James says, well, number one, because it's a clear, beautiful sky, we can see all the stars, it tells us there's no threat of rain tonight, so that's a good thing. Astrologically, we can look to the heavens and see that all the constellations are in arrangement, that what Jesus has told us to do will be good things. And finally, we can see, you know, a sense of direction. We know where we're headed. We know what we're doing. We have a good sense of what we're doing here. James says, that's all fine and good, but I was thinking somebody stole our tent. You're welcome. But that missionary sense, that sense of being sent out two by two, it tells us in the scriptures, why would Jesus send them out two by two? Well, because they needed a witness. One person who would be able to affirm what the other person was saying. Jesus tells us in other scriptures that it's important for us to have witnesses in life. And Jesus needs us to be faithful witnesses. By its very nature, from the very birth of our church with Jesus Christ and the work that we continue to carry out in our church, we are missionary by nature. We carry on what we've already been given. From our very roots, we remember that Jesus himself is a certain way, we could say, a missionary, sent from heaven on high with nothing, to be born in a cold, dark stable to a poor family of Mary and Joseph, to have nothing when he enters into this world, and to take nothing with him when he leaves, but our eternal salvation. And so Jesus himself is a missionary, bringing the Father's word to us who will listen and who will believe. And so the task entrusted to us is we are those two by two. We are those who are sent without anything, that we've received freely and we are to give freely, that we take with us Christ's word in all that we say, in all that we do. We hear that in today's first reading from the book of the prophet Amos, that at times we can be reluctant in our approach. Amos is approached by Amaziah. Amaziah was one of the high court officials. And Amos's approach, if you were to read the lead up in the book of the prophet today, he's in the temple area teaching about how bad the people have been, and that it's time for repentance, for all of them to change their ways, or in God's justice, he will send doom and gloom upon everyone. Nobody likes his message. Nobody wants to change. Nobody wants to hear that God is angry with his people for what they've done, for the ways in which they've turned away from him. And yet Amos feels compelled by the message that he's been given through his prayer, that God has spoken to him and has wanted him to become a prophet. And so Amaziah approaches him and says, please, either number one, be quiet, quit talking, or if you have to keep talking, go talk somewhere else where other people will be disturbed. We don't want to upset the people of this city. Amos's response is beautiful, while reluctant. Amos says, look, this is not my message, and I don't want to be doing this. He tells us, a shepherd, and I'm a dresser of sycamores. If we were to think of dresser of sycamores in today's language, that would be like a tree farmer. That's all I do with my life. I raise sheep, I raise plants, trees, for the good of my own family. That's who I am. And yet, by God's message, this is what I'm to do. And so I can't stop, is basically what Amos tells Amaziah. And we see this all throughout the Old Testament. We can look to all the different prophets, and we can see the same sense of a reluctance to participate in God's mission, to be a prophetic voice. We can think all the way back to Moses. When Moses encounters the burning bush in the desert, and he approaches and he hears God's voice, God tells Moses, I want you to go to the Israelites, and I want you to free my people. I want you to free them from the Egyptians. And Moses has a whole list of excuses. God, I can't do that because I don't know your name. And how are they going to believe me if I don't know your name? And so God reveals his name to Moses. Well, they're not going to believe me, God, because who am I? I have no power. And God tells him, lay down your staff upon the ground, and as he does so, it turns into a snake. He says, you can do this. Moses says, they won't listen to me because, as it tells us in the scriptures, he had some kind of a speech impediment. Many scripture scholars believe that Moses probably had like a stuttering problem. And so Moses uses that as an excuse. People won't listen to me. They won't understand me, or they'll just write me off. And God impels him to go forth. The prophet Jeremiah. It tells us in the beginning of the book of Jeremiah, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. And now it's calling Jeremiah to go out and be a prophet. And Jeremiah's excuse, I can't. I'm too young. Nobody will listen to me. We hear this all throughout the prophets. Jonah. Remember the story of Jonah being swallowed by the whale? Well, how did he wind up in the whale's belly to begin with? He was running away from God's will to go out to the city of Nineveh and preach repentance. He said, I'm not going to do that. And he ran the other way and wound up in the belly of the whale, and finally he gets freed. And he carries out God's message. But then when the people do repent, what was Jonah's response? Then he's angry at God. Why did you give them a second chance? And so we see this reluctancy in all these Old Testament prophets, but it doesn't end there. Think about Peter. What was Peter's reaction when he first encountered Christ on the seashore? His response was, depart from me, Lord. Get away from me. Go away. For I am a sinful man. We think about Paul as he persecuted Christians after Jesus has resurrected from the dead. And as he persecutes, he's knocked off his horse, made blind until he has a conversion. All these different lives that we look to as beautiful examples of messengers of God's word had a reluctance, at a minimum, in the beginning. God calls each and every one of us to carry on that missionary journey. We have been touched by God's love. We've received forgiveness handed down to us through the apostles. We've received healing. We've received the Eucharist. All these special ways in which God fills us, he now impels us to go forth, much like those disciples in today's reading, with only his love, his mercy, and his forgiveness. Why were they told not to take money belts? Why were they told not to take anything else other than one tunic? Because that way, when they did their good works, people would look to them and they would realize they have nothing. And so this must be God doing these good works. So how do we be a mission in the world today? Of course, we continue to pray for the two missionary families as they continue their work in Peru and the Philippines, and those great works. And that's a beautiful missionary work. We continue to pray for missionary priests and religious who work all throughout the world, sharing the gift of faith. But missionary work doesn't need to be done far away in some remote land. Missionary work begins in our homes. As we grow in faith, as we grow in prayer, as we pray with and for one another, as we teach our children how to pray, how to receive forgiveness, and how to be able to forgive. Missionary work begins when we realize somebody's in need, if they're hungry, or if they're thirsty, or if they need a place to sleep. We reach a helping hand to continue the work of Christ in the world. Christ calls his first disciples to continue his mission. And that same mission continues in each and every act of love that we share for one another. May God bless you. Together we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father.
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, only Son, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through all the world, for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And the Holy Spirit was the incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. One day, he ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory. judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, but through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and I look for the world to come. Amen.
Together we are baptized, and together we are called. And so let us pray for all who are in need.
For all missionaries of the church, as they go out into the world two by two, may they bring the good news to eager ears, and may they be kept safe from those who would harm them. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That leaders of nations listen to the prophets who call them to justice, fairness, and integrity. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer in the summer's heat, for those who endure storms, wildfires, tornadoes, and floods, and for all who respond to their needs with generous hearts, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Jamile Rodriguez, who was baptized this weekend, and for her parents and godparents, that they grow daily in faith, hope, and love, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our community of faith, as we, like the 12, take up the call to bring the presence of God to those whom we meet, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are called by God to pursue the priesthood and religious life, and for their supportive families and communities, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Karen Coelho, whose funeral was last week, and for all who have gone before us from death into everlasting life, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the living and deceased members of Holy Family Parish, the intention for which this Mass is being celebrated, and for all of the intentions that remain in our hearts and those that are in our prayer intention book, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, you destined us for adoption through Jesus Christ so that we might be forgiven and redeemed. Graciously hear these our prayers for the world that you love and grant them through Christ our Lord.
As our gifts are being prepared, please join in singing from the Gather, number 777, Here I Am, Lord. Today our gifts will be presented by Ray and Shirley Geiger.
All who dwell in darkest night.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May you accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and will of all his holy church.
Look upon the offerings of your church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that, when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and David our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in singing number 945 in the Gather, I Am the Bread of Life, number 945.
I am the bread of life.
Please join in singing number 903 in the gather, Baptized in Water. 903.
Baptized in water, sealed by the Spirit, cleansed by the blood of Christ our King, heirs of salvation, trusting His promise, faithfully now God's praise we sing. In water, sealed by the Spirit, dead in the tomb with Christ our King, one with His rising, freed and forgiven, thankfully now God's praise we sing. In water, sealed by the Spirit, marked with the sign of Christ our King. Born of one Father, we are His children, joyfully now God's praise we sing.
Having received Jesus' body and blood in this Eucharist, we too, like those first disciples, are called to go forth and boldly proclaim the message that Christ has died, Christ is risen, and that Christ will come again. We pray that God may give us the gift of His Holy Spirit to carry that out in strength as we offer our prayer of thanksgiving. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. One very special mission that we have here at Holy Family Parish is to keep those who are not able to be with us in our celebration of the Mass, involved in our parish liturgies, through the care of our homebound through this Sunday Eucharist. As we invite forward those who will take communion to the homebound this day. And we pray. As you go to the sick and the homebound this day, take with you not only the sacrament that we have celebrated, but also the word of God which we have heard, as well as the prayers and the affection of this parish community. And as you go, ask for the prayers of those whom you visit in return. Go now, we pray, with God's peace and blessing. Amen. Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. In a very special way today, we thank Danny Banky for, she came out of retirement just to serve this morning because we had no other servers. So thank you, Danny, for serving today. She did a great job.
Anyone who had a photo taken by LifeTouch for the photo directory and are waiting for their free 8x10 portrait, you can find your photos in the Narthex. This Tuesday evening, the regular 5:30 Mass will be followed by a presentation by Bob Kroll entitled The Father Wound and Beyond. Bob will speak on the incredible impact a father has on a child. The cemetery mass this week is on Wednesday, July 15th at 6:30 p.m. at St. Patrick's Cemetery in Maple Grove. There was an error in one of the bulletin listings. Parish picnic ticket envelopes, raffle baskets, and sign-up sheets are all found in the narthex.
And you may remember a month or two that we had a couple of our parish staff members come up to talk about the bishop's appeal and how close we were to reaching our goal. And you remember that one of our staff people, Julie, our bookkeeper, business administrator, or business manager, had made some kind of a promise that if we reached our goal, that Father Timothy, much like the little gentleman climbing our little mountain, keeping track of our bishop's appeal goal, that much like that little guy, when we reached our goal, Father Timothy would wear his lederhosen. I'm not one to let a challenge go unnoticed. So, first of all, we owe ourselves a big congratulations. We have reached our bishop's appeal goal. Congratulations, everybody. Good job. Thank you, everybody. Second of all, as soon as we reached our goal, I went on the internet and found a pair of lederhosen. If you want to see me in lederhosen, you have to come to the parish picnic. All day I will wear my lederhosen at the parish picnic. So come on out and enjoy. I hope that doesn't deter people from coming to the parish picnic for this evening. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. As we go out to love and serve the Lord, let us join in singing from the Missalette 334. God's blessing sends us forth.